And now we will learn how to charge late fees to the tenants. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Very often, tenants agree to pay a specific amount in late fee if they pay rent after a specific day of the month. We are already set up to charge late fees and put them on an invoice. A late fee is only one example of how to charge a tenant for something that we earn in income. If you charge for something else that counts as income to you, then you should use this late fee video as an example of how to set it up and how to do it. Do you remember the setup items that we did together? Back at the beginning of the course, after we put in the chart of accounts, we put two items on the items list. We put the monthly rent item that we could list on an invoice, and when we list that on an invoice, the money amount for that gets recorded into this account in the chart of accounts, rental income earned. But we also put in the items list the late fee, and we set it up in such a way that if we put late fees on an invoice, the money amount of the late fee goes into that income account, income from late fees. So this is the first time we're actually putting that item on an invoice, and it makes sense that it would get tracked to a different income account. You can add the late fee to an existing invoice or make a separate invoice to charge the late fee. For example, let's imagine we added $50 to the February 28 invoice for Betty for past and overdue invoices. And at this point, we can predict what the results will be. However, if you remember the earlier video about the items list, we had put the late fee there, but we made it inactive. No problem. Click Sales, Products and Services. Then when you click the funnel arrow where it says Status, change from Active to All. Now when I click Apply, I can see all of the items that I made, even the ones that were made inactive. Now for the late fee, I can just go across where it says Make Active and click. And boom, I'm now able to add a late fee to the invoice. So what was it again? $50 February 28th to increase that last invoice for Betty for the late fee that we're charging her. So we have to click Reports. Now, to find transactions, I like the transaction list by tenant, but you can click the tenant balance detail. I just like the transaction list by tenant. And if you go down to Betty Boop over here, you can see that the second invoice right here, this is the one for Betty on the 28th that we're going to add the late fee. So all you have to do is double click anywhere in this line, and you'll come back to the original window that you charged her the February rent for. Click directly under the first item to bring the arrow for the second item. Click on the arrow and choose late fee. Now you can decide case by case how much to charge, but we're simply increasing this invoice by $50, which means we're increasing Betty's balance by $50. Now when we click save and close, we can come back and we can see Betty, this particular invoice has increased by $50, and therefore what Betty owes us in our records increased by $50. But the most interesting result is here. Click Reports, Custom, and go to Trial Balance. Notice income from late fees shows up for the first time as $50. Now, in our second example, we can imagine a few days into the new month, we made a separate invoice for Dave, $100, just for the late fee. It's the same idea, you just make a new invoice. So we learned sales, invoice, new invoice. That's a little fancier way of clicking the plus sign to get to the invoice window. And of course, the customer is Dave Deeney, and the date that we're giving him this invoice is March 5th. And it's very simple. Click directly under the product service word to bring the pull down arrow for the item. Click the arrow and choose only late fee and put the amount, in his case, $100, and tab. Now, when we click save and close, we can go back to the report that you like. In my case, I like the transaction list by tenant. And you can see for Dave Deeney, his balance has increased by $100. Specifically for this invoice, that's for late fee. Also, if you click Reports, Trial Balance, you can see that income from late fees has increased to $150. And if you double-click the balance, you can check out every single person whom you've charged a late fee for. 50, then another 100 brings it up to 150 for this account, income from late fees.